Welcome everyone! Today we are diving into some recent changes at H5P. This video is your go-to guide for understanding those changes and more importantly, how to navigate them effectively. Stick around as we explore the transformations at H5P and discuss the four options that you can now take since these changes are in effect. Before we dive into the changes at H5P, make sure to check out the description below for more of my videos on H5P and exclusive content. Also, don't miss my Udemy course where I show you how transforming PowerPoint into H5P instructional content can save you a lot of money or make you a lot of money. Now, let's jump into the updates and the options you need to know about right now. Let's quickly talk about H5P. It's a game changer for non-programmer educators like me. This incredible tool allows us to craft impactful teaching and learning resources without breaking the bank. Actually, without costing us a cent, a penny, or a dime, no matter where you're from. H5P empowers us to articulate our ideas seamlessly in PowerPoint presentations, aligning them with what our learners want to interact with in H5P and what our learning management systems is programmed to do. The best part? It's a do-it-yourself solution, challenging the notion that educators need pricey tools and consultants to deliver on their behalf. I believe in educators taking the reins, creating their own content effortlessly with PowerPoint, H5P, and their LMS. The good news is H5P is still here, it's still free, and it's still evolving thanks to the incredible team behind its success. So, what are the recent changes? Let's dive in and uncover not only what's new, but also what steps you ought to take right now to make the most of these changes. Personally, my journey with H5P began by creating an account on h5p.org. I enjoyed experimenting with the interactivities without the need to make changes in my LMS. It might sound a bit selfish, but the free hosting service allowed me to launch activities hassle-free. This approach, while convenient for me, might have played a role in the recent changes at H5P. Regardless of the cause, h5p.org provided a unique advantage. I could try out new content without affecting my LMS. The real game changer was the ability to direct my students there, especially when teaching them these interactive skills. They could complete assignments without requiring access to an LMS hosting H5P, which was particularly beneficial since many of my students don't have LMS access. However, here's the twist. H5P.org no longer supports hosting H5P interactivities. This marks a significant change in the H5P landscape. In the wake of H5P.org no longer hosting interactivities, the landscape is evolving. To continue exploring the vast possibilities of H5P, we now need to create a free 30-day trial account with h5p.com. While h5p.com has been a long-standing player, it's important to note that it is a paid hosting service. The shift reflects the developer's commitment to focusing on providing exceptional software rather than hosting our sandboxes. I understand and support this strategic move, yet it comes with a snag. Fully experimenting and exploring the richness of H5P may require more time than the constraints of the 30-day trial period allow. This could mean, for instance, that my students might not have sufficient time to delve into all the features before the trial expires. I think there are four ways to approach this conundrum. Firstly, take the 30-day trial and make the best of it. Secondly, use a site like Moodle.org where you can sign in as a teacher and experiment and explore with the H5P activities. Unfortunately, larger projects can also not be hosted here for any length of time. So downloads will have to be made to be uploaded again to work on later. For those who love hands-on learning and want more control, here's a third option. Create a local installation of Moodle on your PC and install H5P there. It's a fantastic way to experiment, but keep in mind that this approach has its limitations. While you can test to your heart's content, the challenge lies in not being able to easily share your creations with students on the internet. It's a great option for local testing, but may not provide the online interaction you desire. Fourthly, find someone who will make their Moodle site available to you to learn how to use H5P. For example, I offer students enrolled in my courses access to the My Future Way site, where they, as teachers, can request courses and then create H5P interactivities in those courses and enroll students to test those courses. I explain the process in more detail in the description below. Bye for now, and don't forget to subscribe with the bell to stay alert for future videos on educational topics. Until next time.